ignoring the will of voters and imposing same-sex marriage on Iowa.
The battle to remove three Iowa Supreme Court justices hits the airwaves. The television ad claims all three abused their power when they were part of a unanimous ruling that the state's ban on same-sex marriage was unconstitutional.
Those three justices are up for a retention vote this November, and News Channel 8's Laura Nichols has our top story. Laura.
The ad tells Iowans to send these justices a message. That message is voting no on their retention.
Iowa Supreme Court have become political, ignoring
the ad calls three Iowa Supreme Court justices liberal and out of control.
Out of control judges ignoring our traditional values.
Small business owner and previous Iowa governor Republican candidate Bob Vanderplatz is the force behind it. He is out of town today, so we spoke with him by phone.
The whole ad's purpose is to inform the voters of Iowa that you have a Supreme Court that usurped the will of the people.
In April of last year, the Iowa Supreme Court legalized gay marriage by avoiding a statute that banned same-sex couples from getting married. Iowa District Judge Robert Hansen was one of the first to rule that gay marriage is unconstitutional under Iowa law back in 2007. He says the justices targeted in this ad did nothing wrong.
Those justices did exactly what they were required to do. Namely, to assess the constitutionality of a particular statute.
Marriage. What will they do to other
Hansen said what Vanderplatz is encouraging by this ad
these judges are now on
is an abuse of the justice retention process.
Well, no,
he says the retention vote is for Iowans to make sure justices are fit to judge, not based on popularity and how they have ruled on a particular issue.
And so to me, it's a little bit disheartening to hear judges talk about this is an abuse of the system. They need to go back to the founding where it says we're a government of we the people, and that's why they gave us the retention vote in the first place.
Vanderplatz maintains that the justices went outside their jurisdiction. But Judge Hansen has other advice.
Not to go just on the basis of the content of this ad, but to go further, to go deeper, to educate themselves about the judiciary, about the retention process, so that they can exercise their vote, as I said, in a responsible and knowledgeable way.
Iowans will be able to cast their vote on November 2nd. Now, last Wednesday, retired Supreme Court Justice Sandra Day O'Connor visited Des Moines to express her opinion on the issue. She stated her support for Iowa's judicial selection process and said the nation should follow Iowa's lead.
Laura, have the justices who are up for retention themselves had anything to say about this?
I try to get in touch with each of them today, but an Iowa Supreme Court spokesperson told me they are not commenting at this time.
All right, Laura, thank you.